Hey guys, good morning. Happy Sunday. I am walking to Haymarket right now because I'm going to go to the Suitcase Rummage here in Sydney. It was meant to happen last week, but because of inclement weather, it has been moved to this Sunday. So it's over the area of Haymarket in Ultimo. So yeah, I'll take you there. It's essentially, I'm not sure exactly how often this happens here in Sydney. I think it's like once a month, or like I just follow their Facebook page and see when it happens. But essentially, you're allowed to bring 2 to 3 suitcases full of your stuff that you want to sell. And yeah, so you pick a spot wherever it is. I think there's a payment of $27.50 if you want to sell, but if you're just going, the tickets are free, or you can just go whenever. And yeah, so that's what we're doing today. Okay, so we're passing through the Powerhouse Museum, and I believe that the event is actually at the back of this, close to Paddy's Market already. So here we are, I think I found it. So it is in between, because that's Paddy's Market over there, and this one is, I don't know what this one is. You got books, clothes, shoes. Okay, so there was a Levi's denim jacket over there that I was looking at for $50, and there's that mustard yellow Tory Burch bag. Hi, do you mind if I ask how much the Tory Burch bag is? Yeah, okay. And it's authentic? It's real? Yeah, okay. Okay, so I wasn't really planning on buying anything when I decided to go there. I just wanted to see what the rummage was like, but when you get that kind of a deal of $100 for an original Tory Burch in a color that I've been looking for, it really doesn't make any sense for me to pass up that opportunity. So I walked like maybe 2 blocks to get to an ATM to get $100 cash so that I can buy that bag. Lord knows I don't need another bag. Okay, so while I didn't plan to purchase anything from this rummage sale, I think I had a good bargain. It's $100 for this Tory Burch bag. I'm gonna show you in a little bit. I'm just gonna find a space for me to sit down and show you what it's like. The rummage area itself wasn't really that big. It was just that one straight, winding kind of spot in the area where they just put down their luggages and they go ahead and sell them. Hence probably why they only are asking for $27.50 as the price to like sort of a permit to go there. But yeah, okay, I'm just trying to find where I can sit down. So to be honest, this is an impulse purchase because, as you guys know, I don't need another bag. But since I sold my Michael Kors Selma satchel bag, I had spare cash with me, and I've been thinking of buying a Tory Burch bag for a while, but now but I just didn't want to fork out the cash for it. But today I happened upon one. Now, to be honest, I was a little bit skeptical and I had to do several checks. I don't even know how to authenticate a Tory Burch bag. So anyways, let's give it a go. So here it actually comes with this dust bag, and I do know that the Tory Burch bags come in this kind of dust bag, so that's one good thing happening with that. Now let me see if I can actually open this with just one hand and show you what the bag looks like, or maybe I'll just put the camera in between my legs so that you can see. There you go. So this is the bag. Maybe some of you who are experts in Tory Burch bags can tell me if this looks authentic to you, but all the hardware has got Tory Burch engraved on it. The zippers have got it on both sides as well. Now, typically when I buy branded bags, there is usually an authentication card inside, and I didn't find any in here. I know my Coach bags have got serial numbers even though they are factory outlet bags, but my Michael Kors don't, so I'm not particularly sure how that works. My Calvin Klein bags also don't have serial numbers, so I don't really know how to authenticate them, so I just took her word for it. Like the zipper in here is also engraved with both Tory Burch. The leather is pebble leather, so it looks really nice. There are some cosmetic damages, I would say, just this discoloration from use, I guess. Like the zips and the hardware have got some tarnishing, but that is to be expected when the bag is used. Okay, so, but it still looks good. It looks loved and worn in. So I'm hoping that this is authentic, because that would be a shame to give out $100 for a fake Tory Burch bag. But looks legit to me. There you go. Now, for some reason, I expected the Rummage sale to actually be in an indoor location, but it was just outside. It was pretty much like people gathered together and just opened their suitcases. And I don't see anything wrong with that. They probably got a permit or something, but there was a group of cyclists that came through and they didn't realize that something was going on there. They were quite surprised because I suppose that's their usual route. So I was like, okay, they're gonna have to go through the whole sales section, and it was filled with people, so they had to like slow down. Some of them had to dismount their bicycles for that, but all good. Would I come back? Maybe. I just don't know when the next one is. So if you guys are interested and you live in the Sydney area, I would suggest that you follow their page on Facebook, and that's where they update when they're gonna have the next one. And yeah, I think that was a good experience. I did find one gem. So maybe next time I will find another gem. We'll see. I'll have to check out the next ones and see if there's going to be any good ones available again. I think that's it for me for now. I just wanted to show you what's available out there here in Sydney. And while I didn't get anything in the Glebe's Market when I went previously, this one looked a little bit more promising, and it looked like it was something that actually came from their closet. Now, having said that, as I was walking past, there was a lady who was selling some of her own stuff. And from the distance where I was standing, which is about maybe 5 to 7 feet away from her, I could smell her, like body odor smell. And for that reason, I would never buy anything from her, because even though I always wash and clean the clothes before I wear them, sometimes body odor sticks and it just doesn't go away no matter how much you try to wash it. So, yeah. just for hygiene purposes, I wouldn't do that. I would also probably be worried about this. Probably one of the reasons why I don't normally buy secondhand shoes is because of that. Like, somebody could have fungal infection or athlete's foot or something like that, and I don't want to get that from them. So yeah, but other than that, I'm okay with buying stuff. However, some of these people here were selling undergarments like bras, and I would never buy a secondhand bra. Even though if let's say it's new and it's still got its tags on and whatever, I just wouldn't. It's not something that I would risk. Yeah, so thanks very much for coming with me today. Let me know what your thoughts are. If you have something like this in your city, have you been? And if you have you found gems as well? And let me know, yeah, what you want to see next on this video. Thank you. Bye.